A blessed day and welcome. This morning, we will be meditating on Matthew chapter 5 and verse 9. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Yesterday, we were meditating on the importance of maintaining a humble heart to promote godly unity. In fact, the first characteristic we see in the Holy Trinity is unity. Genesis chapter 1:1-3 and the subsequent verses project the unity between God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In fact, unity is a very powerful godly character. This morning we see Jesus addressing those who maintain and promote peace as his own offspring. The commitment to make peace is highly valued throughout the Bible. But what does it mean to be a peacemaker? Biblically, a peacemaker is someone who reconciles people who were formerly in conflict. The heart of Jesus' earthly mission was to make peace between God and those who would come to him through faith. It makes sense then that everyone who commits to making peace between others, especially by their own sacrifice, imitates what Christ has done. Such a person is not only called blessed, but also a son of God. Beloved, there is a great connection between sonship and brotherhood. Those who claim to be linked to the Father will also strive to maintain good relationships with other sons, reflecting the very nature and character of the Father. On the day of the Battle of Trafalgar, Lord Nelson took two of his captains who were in disagreement to a spot where they could see the fleet that opposed them. "Yonder," said the admiral with a sweep of his hand, "are your enemies." The captains shook hands, forgot their differences in the face of their common enemy, and united together. The biblical illustrator. Isn't that true of those who are of the same faith too? We have only one enemy, the devil, who is always scheming to divide and rule. Let those who belong to Christ be those who strive to prevent contention, strife, and war, who use their influence to reconcile opposing parties and to prevent lawsuits and hostilities in families and neighborhoods. Let's unite together for one cause as citizens of one country, soldiers of the same army, siblings of the same family, to stand up against the common enemy. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, give us wisdom to identify the source of conflict and humbly live with each other. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Shalom, Maranatha.